When I went there, I was so happy that I won the gold in single and won the gold in double. It's like I was so proud of it that I got selected to represent India team to play for the Deaf Olympics. This is my first experience and see whether how you're going to interact with the foreign players and see how you're going to learn from them and see how you're going to make friends with the Deaf players.
A prolific tennis player has won a bronze medal in the Summer Deaf Olympics 2017 and became the world champion in 2019. We have a very special guest with us today, Prithvi Shekhar. Welcome to the show, sir.
Hello, ma'am. Yes.
How are you doing, sir? How has it been yes. for you lately?
Yes, I'm doing so good and great. I'm happy about that you have been inviting me to attend this interview to be a part of this company named as Sports Tiger. So I'm definitely happy that you can you answer my questions, so which I can answer for you in detail.
Well, we are happier to have you with us today, sir. Thank you so much for joining us, and it's an absolute pleasure to host you today.
Thank you so much, your pleasure, and you are welcome so much.
To start with, when and how did it all start for you? How did you start playing tennis? How did you get into the sport?
Okay, so I was not born by a normal child. I was born by like a child with a non-able to hear anything. So my parents took me to one school named Kolat Bala Vidyalaya, where they need to teach me how to communicate and how to speak myself and how to learn something. So I studied in the school named Kolat Bala Vidyalaya. So all the teachers are supporting me and helped me to communicate and learn something to talk with English, and like alphabet letters and everything, how to write down and everything. Then once I'm done with the Bala Vidyalaya school, then I'll move to my CBSE school, which is in a Bala Vidya Mandir. So my parents asked me, what game you like to play? I said, I like my game cricket. Then they took me some park to see whether I'm able to play cricket or something. Then after that, then they said that, let us not go for cricket, because if you want to play cricket for a future, you may not think whether you will be selected to play and represent the team or not. Whether depends how many players we get selected.
Yeah.
So I was so happy that my parents took me at the individual game and asked me to go for tennis and just try it in team. So I started playing tennis at the age of 8. So I got some experience and I got my everything where with my sports helped me and taught some basics about tennis, like what is tennis and what is you need to work on or something. So that is how my parents were supportive and helped me to choose the individual game at tennis.
Okay, that's a brilliant story, sir, and it's amazing to see how at every point your parents were there to support you. You had your teachers there who supported you, who taught you, and who really groomed you into who you are today and are a major part of your success today. It's absolutely amazing to hear that, sir. So, did you ever at any point in your life, did you feel demotivated that you will not be able to do it? Or, how did you overcome the impairment and, how did you motivate yourself against all odds?
The thing is, I will not say that I'm a deaf child. I have to say that I'm a normal child, which I'm able to hear everything, like the car or bike or pressing horn. I'm able to hear everything. So I have not think that I'm not supposed to be like, I'm riding hearing machine. Oh, I'm thinking that I should be a deaf child. It's not like that. I should not say that I'm 100% as a normal child. The thing is, if I remove my hearing aid machine, I won't be able to hear anything. It's just fine. It happens for everyone. So I told my parents, I'm 100% sure that I will never say that I'm a deaf child. I will prove that I'm a normal child, which I can do and able to speak, able to communicate able to get a bike or car with a driving license and everything, which I can able to hear properly. So the first, when I was so small, I was so sad, upset, and crying that, oh shit, everybody was able to talk over the phone. And like, how I'm going to talk over the phone? Like, whether should I stop being like a normal child and go for a ride or something, or to learn like sign language or something? I was so upset. And my parents told that and supported. I have an elder brother, and he also told me that you have to worry about it. Just be freely, be calm. Nothing will happen. You are such a brave and normal child. You will definitely come up and do the picture, and you will definitely become a normal child, and you will everything take care of everything, and definitely do well in the tennis, and you will also perform well, and you will do a good job and take care of everything, your family, everything. So that is how I was demotivated and felt sad that I was becoming a deaf or not something. So that is why I was something like upset or something.
Absolutely, you know, I think you all along had a positive approach, and everyone around you were so positive and so supportive and motivating for that matter, that they never made you feel as if, you know, you were any different. And definitely, you know, you have proved yourself as well. You've won so much, you've done so much for the country, and all of us are proud of you today, sir.
Thank you so much. And also the thing is, I studied in Bala Vidya Mandal up to 1st standard to 9th standard, and I took care of myself. I will not support. See, the thing is, basically people sit in the school and sit in the last bench. So if I want to sit in the last bench, means I won't be able to hear what teacher is explaining or communicating about the study. So basically what I used to do, sit in the first bench so that I can clarify the doubts from my anything where I teacher explain or something. That will be my benefit, where I can listen properly. And then after that, after 9th, I find it difficult. So I'm not able to manage tennis and CBSE studies. So my parents told me that if I go to the matriculation school, and definitely you can manage studies, and you can play a couple of hours to play tennis. So I studied from 9th standard to 12th standard within nearby school named all Kumar Rani Meena Muthiah Matriculation Higher Secondary School. So once the 10th board exam got over, parents asked me, what course do you want to take? Either you want to take biology or computer science or commerce. I said, I go for science group. I'm comfortable with chemistry, physics and everything. I'm comfortable, I told them. And they asked me, what language do I choose? And my parents told me that go for French, just try it and see. And my principal was happy and proud of it. He asked me to learn some new language called German. So let me try it and go for German. So once I completed 12th, I scored the highest mark in German.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So that was being supported by a German man, where she helped me a lot and learned some. See, we can learn some good languages which we can use to go abroad and learn how to speak with other people.
Correct.
It's not you can learn only English. You can learn different languages. Like if you're learning German, you can go to Germany and talk with the German people and see how you're communicating, whether you're able to talk well or not.
Yeah.
After that, once I finished my flight, my parents asked me, what do you want to do? Either you want to go counseling, or do you want to play studies and play tennis? I said, I'm comfortable for anything. My best option is I go to manage studies and play tennis. So I joined as a postdoc in SRM University.
Okay.
And they appointed me as a postdoc as full scholarship. Nothing to pay any fees, nothing. So they'll take care of everything. I play for the team. I studied B.Tech IT in engineering. I'm the only person that studied IT engineering as a sports quota.
Okay.
Which I managed studied everything like without any single arrear. It's like the thing is, the first year when I joined, I was supposed to write 5 subjects. Out of 5 subjects, I wrote only 1 subject because I have to play for the team to play the South Zone and All India International. And the second semester, there was a regular subject, 8 subjects. So 8 plus 4 older subjects. So 12 subjects, 12 subjects. I managed everything in like the old subject the next day evening and the regular subject the next day morning. So it's like I'm comfortable. I managed everything without anything clear. I cleared everything, nothing, a single arrear. So that's how I prove myself that I can do it. I believe everything. I'm able to study and able to manage and everything.
Absolutely.
And even SRM was so proud of me that I play for a team and we won the gold medal for a team.
Yeah.
And then after the fourth year is you have to do some internship projects and all that is important for SRM that you have to show that. After that, whether the placement is compulsory or not, it depends on me or it not depends on my parents. Either you have to get a job or you may continue doing MBA.
Hmm.
If you want to do MBA, means you can continue playing tennis.
Yeah.
For another 2 more years, because for 4 years I've not played tennis like with not 100% intensity. I was playing okay, like half an hour, 45 minutes, but it's not enough. If you want to come up to the level and go for a higher tournament or something, I said I want to do MBA and continue 2 more years and see. I'll prove that I'll perform well and come up in a good level and come up with a good ranking, I told them.
Yeah.
So I didn't attend the placement. I directly went and do again MBA in the same SRM university where they appointed me as a sports quota. So out of these 6 years, I managed everything and we won 4 gold, 1 bronze and 1 7th position where I play for SRM.
Okay, wow.
So it's like all me, supported by parents and my brother, everything they were supported and say that you have to worry about it. Capable of studying and able to play tennis, everything.
Yeah, absolutely, sir. I mean, the way you've managed your academics, you've taken like 12 subjects, in the same exam period. It's commendable. And along with that, you've won so many laurels for your university. So I'm sure your university had that trust in you. They believed that you could do it and you did do it for them. Not just in sport, but also in academics. You know, you balanced everything out. I think you were just the perfect student that every university looks for.
Thank you so much. Yeah. And also, I want to say that it's not only you have to think that on the deaf side. See, and then my mom told me that how am I supposed to speak over the phone? Like people generally talk over the phone like this. For me, for the hearing machine, the machine is over there, the voice to put to the phone. So one of my very close teacher helped me and told me that you have to because. That is the voice over there, so you have to keep your phone over the machine. So once I thought that, oh my god, now I got it, that I can speak over the phone, I talk well and communicate so well. So that's what they supported my parents as well as my close teacher, where she told me how to talk over the phone. That's how I am able to believe I can do myself and see how I can do. I should not follow others that. Oh, he's a normal child. I'm not saying I prove myself that I can do everything and take care of everything.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. That's definitely the most important thing.
Yeah. And so, even once MBA is done, I have to think what I'm going to do next. So after the 3 months, I did after I passed my SRMC on May 2017 and decided what to do next. So I got an appointment, I attended the selection flight and got an appointment in ICF, which is a part of Railways, and I appointed to sports quota.
Okay. That's really commendable, sir. Yes.
So I've been playing for the team and we won the silver medal. And once you got a silver medal, where you play for a team at Railway, they have given me a 330 days leave, which means you have to come to office anytime.
Okay.
And then in May 2019, we play for the Indian Railway, where we have to go and play in Bulgaria, that we won the gold medal. Again, they have given 330 days leave again. So Railway, they have been so proud and they are supporting the everything. This was absolutely all parents and my brother were supported by me for sure, which I was able to manage in and got a good job where railways have been supported, where you are able to play with two sports quota, which you can play full-time tennis and see what you can do for the future and how I'm going to perform some higher level tournaments.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. So from there, now let's move on to 2013. Your first appearance at the Deaflympics, donning the Indian jersey. So tell us how it happened and tell us how you felt playing that tournament and, you know, in that jersey.
Yeah. Actually, the thing is, my mom found out and saying that, oh, there's one Deaf Games coming up where the Deaf Olympics, the Deaf Olympics have been started earlier, like 1890 or 1919 something. So my mom found out that, oh, there is a Deaf Olympics coming in 2013, which means which we can play and see whether can we get selected or not. Then my mom found out some person and contacted them. Oh, yes, there is a national game for Deaf. It is happening in Aurangabad. And then when I went there, I was so happy that I won the gold in single and won the gold in double. Like, I was so proud of it that I got selected to represent India team to play for the Deaf Olympics. This is my first experience and see whether how you're going to interact with the foreign players and see how you're going to learn from them and see how you're going to make friends with the Deaf players. So when I went, so I got selected and went to Bulgaria and singled a lot of first round. It's okay, doesn't matter. Which means I can do and learn my mistakes and do some experiences which can be crucial, like where you can play for India team more and more. And so in the doubles and mixed doubles, I came to quarterfinals. Wow, that was the quickest where I came to quarterfinals. That was the best performance in 2013 where I played for India team. Maybe I was happy about it. I don't care what everybody says, whether they want a medal. I don't care. I care only myself, whether I can prove myself and see how I'm going to do my best. It's not that, oh, since the aim is I have to win my medal. It's not just that. You are doing, go there, perform your game and see how you prove your best. That's it.
Absolutely. Absolutely, sir. You know, it's about the spirit of the sport that you play. It's about the happiness that it gives you. And that's what's special about sports, right? You know, it gives you a different feeling when you're playing a sport. You know, no other field can give you that feeling of satisfaction. You know, I'm a sports person myself, so I definitely understand the meaning of, you know, playing for the sport and not for winning all the time.
Yeah.
So from there, let's now fast forward to 2017, where you participated and you won medals. You know, how was it and what did you do different this time as opposed to the last Olympics that you played?
Yeah, absolutely. The thing is, in 2013 in Delhi, the thing is, I'm the one, see, there are some few players like me, they can talk like that. But other players, they're not able to talk. They can't hear, but they can't talk anything. So they use sign language. So we have to use sign language when we go there for Deaf. We are not supposed to talk. No other players are supposed to talk. The thing is, when you go inside the match, importantly, we have to remove the emission. If you are not removed, you have been disqualified. Okay. That means I have to learn some rules where they have to learn and see for the future. The thing is, when I knock the door, if people cannot hear or talk, it's going to be difficult. It's like how we have to call people, say that the time for a match, or the time for a camp to attend fitness or go for dinner, breakfast, anything. So what I have to do is, I have to go down to reception, take one card and open it, and I have to wake them up. It's like kind of work. For people to support and help them where they can't talk or they can't hear anything, something. So that was the first experience at all. I said, definitely I can do it. We can all help people to wake up and do something. So this was happening. I also, 2015, I played the first World Deaf Championship in Nottingham. That was the best performance I played. I played in singles, doubles, mixed doubles, all by quarterfinalists. I came overall position as a sixth position.
Wow.
Then back to 2017, the second Deaf Olympics where I represent India team and see how I prove my best. In singles, I came to quarterfinals. but it was a close match. But three-quarter finish, what a tough match. But the match lasted for 3.5 or 4 hours, where it was a tough match. It was a tough match. And then quarter finish, I lost in the third set, whether I can get a chance of going to entering a semi-finals to make sure whether I can get the bronze medal to earn it or not. So, okay, singles and doubles I lost in the quarters, and mid-doubles were crucial. Whether semi-finals is going to be third or fourth position. Fourth position, won't earn a medal. For third position, you earned a medal. Actually, my partner, she was shaking and she was having so much pressure, like how I'm going to win my match. I'm a little bit afraid whether I should slow down or should I hit the ball or should I push or something. She was afraid. I said, you have to worry about it. We are here to win the match. We can do it. So what I did, I ran here and there, and we won the match, and we're so proud of it that India was the first medal where tennis made a first medal in tennis for the deaf. Before and now, nobody played for tennis anything. 2017 was the first medal in tennis where that Prithvi and our partner won the bronze medal in mixed doubles in the deaf Olympics. That was being so proud, and the parents were so happy, so proud of it, and everybody, my friends, family, everybody was so happy. And also, Leander Paes won the first medal in 1986 in the Olympics. None of the players have won the Olympics. Owen Bopana, Sana Meja, or none of them. They have won in Asian Games. I am the second person won the bronze medal in the Olympics.
Yeah.
So that was the biggest achievement, and so so proud of it, and happy that I can do better and aim for next medal to come up and do well for the next depth tournament.
Absolutely, sir. I think the proudest of all must be your mother, because she was the one who found out about the tournament and actually put you, you know, enrolled you into the tournament in the first place. So I think she must have felt the proudest, and it's a fantastic feeling, I'm sure, for a parent to see their child do something so big and something so huge for the country. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, sir, now coming on to, you know, the aspect of the government, you know, how important a role has the government played in the upliftment of tennis for, you know, this category?
Actually, basically, when I won the first medal in 2017, the Deaf Olympics in bronze medal, no one congratulated everything. No one did not support for deaf and all, nothing. They were only supported by normal Olympics and Paralympics. So it's like, see, the thing is, one part is normal, second part is para, and third part is deaf. So these all are different parts. They all are separate. It's to not divorce something like that. They should not all should be combined and keep it as one part. They don't care about how much awards you should be. I don't care. I don't mind whether I can get 50,000 or 1 lakh. I don't mind. It's fine. They give, that means I'm happy. I don't mind how much that normally 75 lakhs and deaf is 25 lakhs. It's okay. I am not caring about it. Once the government is supported by everything, all the three parts, then we are happy about it. So that's what the like, government did not do anything. So what we did, we all complained to media and told Modi and the president, everything, something. Why we are not supporting anything for deaf? Why can't deaf not be part of the child? They should support and offer something for cash over for us. So when I won the gold medal in singles and bronze medal in the doubles, where I played the second World Deaf Championship in Turkey, the next year, March 2020, I have approved that deaf and normal cash award will be the same. Which means they'll definitely chance to each and every player who won the medal, they'll give any cash award. Now, right now, they can't give the cash award now. It's because due to pandemic, COVID lockdown. So they may give any time. Once the lockdown is over or once the COVID gets better and better, they will definitely get chance. Actually, I was nominated at the Arjuna Award. I've been applied that. That time, not even a single person for deaf and not got any Arjuna Award this year. So they were only fully supported by PARA. Then we complain that please consider for deaf for Arjun Award to be considered as for next year 2021. And they said, yes, I'll be considered and we will do the best and to select which person can get the Arjun Award for 2021.
Yeah.
And in 2019, the Turkey second World Championship, I was so happy and proud of it that I won the gold medal. The gold is the biggest achievement. I don't know how I came up and performed my tennis tournament. The thing is, in the pre-quarter finals, I was so shocked and pressure whether I was losing the same guy where I lost in 2018. And 2019, I fought back and the match lasted for 4.5 hours. I won the third set, the 7-6. Oh my God, 7-6 was a close match. So it's like I won the match. It's like 4.5 hours where it's like over a big net progress to the quarters. And in 2018, I lost the same guy where I won the same guy in second world championship in the pre-quarter finals. But match lasted for 4.5 hours where I won the third set at 7-6 in the tie break. And the next match, the quarter finals, that was the tougher. See, the tournament is not so easy. It's not easy to get a medal. So I won straight and I just got focused. I was confident. I'm saying that, oh shit, I'm going to lose. No, I said, I believe I can do it. Let's go. Come on. I said, keep doing that. And semi-finals, final. This was the first we have been entering the first final in the second World Championship and trying to earn the gold or silver medal. Once I won the gold medal, I was so happy. I lied down my coat and was so happy and everybody was, oh my God, India was the first medal who won the second World Championship in tennis, where he was the best player in India, where he has been recently winning all tournaments. And then in 2019, December, the International Sports Committee of Deaf have been awarded as the Best Sportsman of the Year.
Yes.
Where I've been performing all these tournaments from beginning until now. So they have been selected as me as the Best Sportsman of the Year. I'm so happy and proud of it, which means I can do and come up and practice, work harder and do my best and focus on the tournament. See, the thing is, for deaf tournaments, it's only conducted for once in a year. They don't conduct the normal tournaments. So my aim is focused on normal tournaments like ITA or ITF and see aim is whether you can get in the Grand Slam or not. That is your best. So my aim for deaf is, the next aim is, I am going to earn the gold medal and do my best in the Deaf Olympics, where you're going to be in Brazil in 2021. That is my aim. That is the Deaf part is separate. The normal part is my aim is see whether I can break in top 600 or 500 in the ATP and see whether I can do it or not.
Well, absolutely, sir. With the way you've been performing and the way in the World Champion you defeated some of the top seeds, I'm confident that you will definitely achieve that through the course. So with that, we've come to the end of our first segment. We'll move on to our next segment, which is called Ace. And here I'll be sharing my screen and there'll be a few questions on your screen. So you need to, answer them and I'll give you 15 seconds for each question. I'm former world number one. I'm the first Indian to win the All England Open Badminton Championship. Who am I?
Former world number one. I the badminton. I usually watch something in badminton, but I get. I may not know the oldest one, but I may know only. Kidambi Srikanth. So that's what I know the player for that.
Let me give you another clue. His daughter is also a very famous Bollywood actress.
I may not know who is she, but.
Okay.
I can know only the few players, Sania Nawal, PV Sindhu, Kidambi Srikanth, and all I knew that are the best Indian players that have been watching badminton so far.
No problem, sir. The answer is Prakash Padukone.
Prakash Padukone.
Okay. Yes. Let's move on to the next question. I was born in Gujarat. I currently play for Mumbai Indians. Who am I?
I think I go for Jatri Mumbai.
Yes, absolutely. I am currently ranked number 4 in the world. I have just one French Open title to my name. Who am I?
Obviously, this is my most favorite time player. It's Roger Federer.
Yes, absolutely correct. I hail from Assam. I'm also known as the Dhing Express. Who am I?
Okay. This is one of the athletic championship, but I've seen somewhere. Yes. But sometimes I know like PT Usha or something, but I not know that this girl name. I don't know, remember.
You want to take a guess, sir?
But I'm not seen much athletic, but I don't remember the girl's name.
Okay. That's Hima Das. Next one is, I play for Bengaluru FC. I have scored a total of 72 goals in 115 international matches. Who am I?
Obviously, he's the most Indian captain in football. His name is Sunil Chhetri.
Yes, absolutely correct, sir. Well, that's the end, and I think you've done really well in that segment of the quiz as well.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, sir. I have just one last question from my end. I think you've somewhat answered that. You said that you want to be in the top 500 of the ATP ranking. Yeah. But what I want to know from you is that how would you like to achieve it? What's your plan to achieve that?
The thing is, you can't play tennis full-time and you need to think what you want to do in the future. So if you want to play full-time tennis, you need to get a government sponsor or something where some people can sponsor to travel any part of the tournament or something. See, the thing is, for that fit, it's okay. That's it. Sport Authority of India is paying full sponsor, like accommodation, room, food and all for depth. That depth is a bit. If I want to go to normal tournaments, you need some sponsor or something. So basically, I was thinking that whether I can become a travel coach or become a good coach where I can coach people, where I can travel with these students and explain them how to focus on tournament and what to cut it and how to learn to win points and how to interact and see how the foreign players are playing and what is the biggest difference between the Indians and abroad, how they were able to react so far, react to movement here and there, and how they are winning points, or how the stroke change, something. I may need to think something like that. It's not like that you have to work full time at a government job. It's not like that. What happens in ICF is only two sports quota. It's not only I'm not gone to under non-sports quota. Through sports quota means you can balance your little bit time of work and manage your food, tennis or coaching or whatever, or a fitness coach, whatever, something. So that is my future for the next few years, I'm thinking. So that is how I need to think about it. And after that, there are some friends are calling me and asking me to come and do something for a future, which we can do together as a group, like a business group or something, where we can coach some people and travel somewhere here and there, where we can interact with these players and be as with the family to perform our best and see how we are going to do the to prove whether we can get the WTA or get in the ATP and see. Maybe you can get experience with some Roger Federer, Novak Djokovic, Nadal, or Simona Halep, Serena, to get some experience and see whether you can play with them or not.
Yeah.
Recently, I've been knowing Somdev, Jeevan, Rajnish Gunneswaran, Ram Kumar. I've been playing with most of the time, Rajnish and Ram Kumar called me to come and play with me. So, yeah, I'm always very best friend with them, where I can get some experience, which will
Correct.
Be useful for the future and see how you can come up to that level.
Correct.
So even Somdev called me, like come play for football. See, that's how if you instead of with dub players, I'm become to getting close and close, and you can play after sometimes. Let's come and play double. You can go win title. Something you have to get interact with some players. That is really useful, and you can decide on through that I can earn the grand slam and see how I'm going to get into the perform your their best. That's it.
Absolutely, sir. I think that's a brilliant roadmap for you to achieve what you want to achieve in your life. And I am confident that you will achieve whatever you wish to, and you will continue doing so much for our country and winning all those laurels that you've been winning. Thank you so much for joining us today. And it was truly inspirational to hear from you, your entire journey, the way you've balanced every single thing in your life, from your school, your college, to your academics, your sports, and also your finances. It's absolutely commendable to see how you have done everything, you know, by yourself with the support of your family. Thank you so much, sir.
It was a pleasure talking to you.
And yes,
your holy pleasure. I'm so happy that this is how many people are interviewing me, which is me. It makes me so happy, and get some experience to interview some questions where people may call me, as definitely I want to teach you and learn some tennis basic for me, where I can help them and do the, their own best how they are performing the tournament.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. Thank you so much, and it was a pleasure talking to you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Deborah.
So, you know, you've represented at the Olympics two times, and you know, so was representing India at the Olympics, you know, always a goal?
I have represented two times, but now it's the time to grab that gold.